Hello and welcome to Friday Afternoon here on twitch.tv/DDOstream and youtube.com/DungeonsandDragons/live. Give us a follow on Twitch if you want to be notified for when we go live with shows just like this one. Also, give us a subscribe button hit on YouTube and we'll show up in your subscription feed. It seems to be where most people are watching our videos here, at least on the YouTube side of things. So, nice to have you here. We're on Kyber. I got some friends with me. Let me get over so my voice chat works. Hey, Erlock, nice to have you here. Also, Zachaos, is that how I'm saying it right? That's Patrick from DDO Cast. And sorry, I don't know how to say your name. I'm not sure who you are, other than you're a guildie with the Kobold Consortium, so.
Good to be here. Let's have some fun in some Haunted Halls.
Indeed. Hey, Wizenman, how you doing? Nice to have you here. Hey, Bortek, good to be back. We're on Kyber this week just because I wanted to say hello. I'm assuming you maybe don't have voice chat, huh? Is that right, Patrick? I'm not sure.
No, I should have voice chat.
Okay, yep, I'm hearing you fine. You've just been quiet. Come on, man, you're a podcaster. You need to talk. I'm kidding.
Yeah, I'm taking my opportunity not to talk.
Okay. So, well, but I wanted to get you on the show just to talk a little bit about what you've got going on. So you're going to be taping DDO Cast this weekend. Let's start off with a little shout-out for that, huh?
Yeah, we should be live 6 p.m. Pacific time, 9 p.m. Eastern on Saturday. We're going to continue our series on spell selection with bards and artificers.
Cool. Have to get into the insightful damage and strikes, right? Because that's the big spell. That, although, you know, actually, I have started using tactical detonation, which is something I really never did for a long time. And I've actually found it fairly useful, circumstantially.
Oh, it's great for breaking boxes and for killing monsters.
Yeah. Otherwise, I use, my brain's skipping my head. It's the one that gives you the little purple spike, ghost spikes on your back. You know which one I'm talking about? Gives you a slight boost to damage.
Tensor's Transformation.
There you go, Tensor's Transformation. That's a good one. I pretty much always keep up on my Artificer as well.
Did we decide Elite or Hard?
We're doing Hard. I'm just not ready to do Elite. I want to live, kind of.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. Also not extended because this is my first time running it. So I need to do the normal before I do extended. Hey Xylo, nice to have you here.
What is the Artificer spell? It's a little low level zap spell, but it also dazes. Using that with a wizard spell.
No, that's the one of the electric ones, right? I can't think of the name right now.
Lightning. Oh, the hand grenade. There it is. Yeah. There it is. A hand grenade.
Okay.
You were at the entrance to the lair of the infamous bandit king, Rivior. Tales of twisting corridors and deadly traps dissuade most travelers from entering.
Turn up the audio just a little bit. You guys can hear Mr. Greenwood.
You know, actually play a rogue and go sneakily down the hall.
Yeah, so how roguey are you? Are you pretty trap-worthy here?
Oh, very.
Cool. I'll make things easier.
I think it ended up with a 117, 120 disable.
That should work.
Not bad.
Everybody rolls ones.
And that's why I carry those. Trap.
So, let's see, what can I talk about this weekend? Crystal Cove kicked off yesterday. We have lowered the turn-in rate to be very generous as well. So, excuse me, I do have a bit of a cold
I can't
today,
wait to run
so.
This in my the permadeath flat group. And at least
oh, I know, for sure, yep.
We lit that one.
So we're just going to say we did lower the turn-in rates for Crystal Cove. That started yesterday. It's 500 on all the servers and 250 on Wayfinder. Now, the basic idea is, you know, if you want to run the mining challenge a bunch, we want to let you. So that's pretty much what's going on there. It's at the point that you can pretty much solo it if you want to. I mean, you could get 500 yourself in about... Well, if you've got a pirate grog, probably an hour. With Butcher's Path.
I haven't run this in a long time.
Yeah, I haven't actually either. Yeah, nice Civic. 750 map pieces sitting in the bank from last year. That sounds good. Xylo asks a question, can we talk about when Otto's boxes will hit the store again? They were just on sale, what, a couple weeks ago. So it might be a little while before they come on back. I think it was 2 weeks ago that they were on sale. Memorial Day, maybe? Memorial Day weekend. So I guess it's been about a month now. But it's going to be a little while, I think. But hearing on the forums how much you guys want to have updated loot for Crystal Cove, I'd just reiterate that we hear you, but it's not in the
red box.
Not in the immediate plan.
The jumping favored soul didn't give you the hint?
Nah, I thought you were just having fun. There you go.
Yeah, right. I would reiterate something I said on the forums here. We have identified an the issue that was causing the doppelganger to not work properly in here. So that should be fixed for update 32. And we basically put a workaround in place so that if it kind of breaks, so to speak, it's just going to bypass
this
you.
Gate
open
like
up the gate, get your thing.
By a mechanism.
At least I think that's something like that anyway.
Very much sweet.
Yeah, it ended up being a fairly complex scripting issue, so in order to, I guess, quote, fix the issue, we'd really have to rebuild that entire encounter from the ground up, and it was just kind of easier to say, well, rather than rebuild it, let's just create a bypass mechanism in there.
We go on the direct straightaway method, or are we going to wander around?
Got an hour to kill. I'm up for whatever.
Yeah, same.
Yep. Let's just go the direct method and then just fill in the gaps, huh? Otherwise, I would just reiterate, and we could actually maybe talk about this a little bit, Didiocasty. I can get a bit promotional, perhaps, at the end of the show here. We can talk about the sales that continue through the weekend. This is going away through, this is through July 4th, so this is your kind of chance to get it, right? We have some massive discounts on both the Didio market and Steam. So it's a really good opportunity if you do not have this stuff. I mean, frankly, you're never going to find it lower than this. So, and I don't mean that to be salesy. I mean that to be, yes, I mean it. It's like 75, 85% off on some of this stuff here. So I would recommend, if you're interested, this is the time to do it.
If you don't have Menace of the Underdark or Epic Destinies and all the stuff that comes with the most 2-pack, now's the time to get it. It will probably never be cheaper.
Also, a quick, and people on the forums have mentioned this as well, but a quick opportunity to get, check out Premium as well. By picking up, say, like a starter pack for $2.50, and we'll make your account premium.
That was a nice premium handling, too, if I remember right.
Yeah, for low levels, anyway.
Oh, he's also just good for having a general, door opener.
Must have caused them to overload, no thanks to that reckless doppelganger.
True. I thought that's what arty pets were for.
killed me,
sputters the doppelganger as he collapses.
You can take my belongings.
A crest. Unfamiliar, but it looks important.
Hey, Jerry. Was interviewing Ed Greenwood one of the highlights of your tenure?
Absolutely. No, it was... I honestly, like meeting a rock star is what it was. It was the most awesome thing I've done. And, like, when I hear him say these lines, I was there when he recorded them, so I can, like, look at his facial expressions and all that sort of thing. It kind of adds this layer to it that's been really interesting. He really got into character for the doppelganger. Like, he was putting on kind of some acting and stuff. It was cool.
Beyond the great doors, the central passage of Rigor's Halls rises in cascades of grandiose steps. Whatever treasures and dangers, this desolate place
holds. The grandkids, I'm asking you about it.
Beyond the barrier is Rivier's throne room, where the bandit lord once flaunted his wealth.
For those curious, I know it's a little old news for a lot of people, but maybe not for everyone who's watching. We do have the full interview up on our YouTube page.
It's a good listen, if you haven't ever listened to it.
Ooh, treasury room.
Otherwise, let's see, what do we talk about here? I know on the Players' Council, No Worries is working through some more Caneth crafting stuff. That should be hitting the live servers fairly soon, I would think, in terms of the info. We're still looking at loot, making some good loot changes based on your feedback.
Three doors.
It's going to be interesting for the main loot for Update 32, without any spoilers, but the fact that you can, one item can fit into two slots.
Yeah, right. That is a big change. You know, we talked about that a little on Wednesday. Someone, Shoemaker, had commented that it didn't seem right that you couldn't pick which slot it was in, but it was really kind of a technical limitation of being able to do this, right? So, for example, you could, I can't remember exactly what the right slots are, so I may be wrong here, but it's like bracers and ring, or bracers and gloves, or maybe boots and gloves. Boots and bracers? Yeah, boots and bracers, maybe. And so you'll be able to just pick it, but it's going to default, if it's just in your hotbar and you double-click, it's going to default to whatever it's listed as in the description first. And that was really just because we would need to create new tech to be able to assign it that way. You can still just drag it to wherever you want, but if you're just clicking on it in your hotbar, so if you're a big hot swapper, you know, it might be a little bit of an extra step for you.
Still, I mean, you can complain about that, but it's the first time we've been able to do that, so...
Right, I mean, really, it came down to either we deal with that sort of limitation, or we just make it a one-slot item, and, you know, it didn't seem like a big enough deal to... Yeah, it didn't seem like a big enough deal to say no, although I recognize, you know, people who like to hot swap a lot are, you know, maybe going to be a little inconvenienced by it.
Be inconvenienced by only being able to put it in one spot anyways, so.
It's also a set bonus thing, so, you know, maybe the goal is you want to keep it on more than not.
It's coalescing from the negative magic of the necromancers and undead. You'll need to clear them from the doorway to get through.
How is our
lag?
Getting
trouble, there's web trap sound back here.
Ah.
They will stop them.
Nice. Yeah, it's working great.
I just wish, webs are great in that bit, I just wish there was more, traps that actually worked for, you know what I mean.
Well, they were designed, you know, pre-epics, so I don't know that they necessarily are meant to scale that high. Although, Situationally, they're still pretty useful.
Lunchbox.
No more zombies will be made here, but undead are still spilling forth.
Let's see. So anyway, Xylo asks, how is our buyback lag reduction looking? So, interesting you mentioned that. It looks like
doing any spoilers, I really do like the way Canocrafting is going.
Ah, nice. So, I was actually going to mention, so Xylo asks, how's the buyback lag coming along? The answer is, we had one of our engineers look at it, and it looks like it's a Sarlona thing. That's why we were getting scattered reports of mine's not causing any problems, and some people are. Come to find out there's something happening on Sarlona where the stuff isn't cleaning itself up like it's supposed to. So it's like, I don't know, basically stuck. And so we're working to unstick it. And so that should be coming in the next update here.
I blame the Thieves Guild. Yeah.
Yeah, hopefully this is just a, you know, temporary thing. If someone did it deliberately, well, they're causing lag for everyone on Sarlona, so good for you.
The rem chest here open, and I got the first one.
Now, we're still actually trying to figure out why it stopped working on Sarlona, but that's what's going on there.
But it's Samus and Lester's fault.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say, is, you know, we should definitely blame Samus for it. What's that sort of knife arc thing you're doing there, Patrick?
Wild Chats from Shirati.
And you found it pretty useful, huh? I never really used it in my Shirati life.
If you're not really going to use a lot of this stuff in there, it does probably 1,200 points of damage for me. Yeah. And it hits like anything it passes through, so yeah. Kind of like a, it's not like a rune arm except it goes through things.
Yeah.
Actually, I think the rune arm from Mark of Death is the same kind of tech.
No, it's eternal.
Oh, really?
Thing.
This is
okay.
One of Rivior's treasure.
I think so, yeah.
Amazingly, still here after all these years. But if the bandit,
it's at least the same graphic.
Is true, there must be even.
That's a lot of crowns.
Yeah, that's pretty common for this final fight here.
No, there's 8 Helm Horrors, and 7 of them are crowned.
Nice.
That's a lot of crowns.
Well, you seem to have the Midas touch for the mysterious remnant chest, so we'll let you do all that killing, okay?
Yeah, it's like an episode of Game of Thrones.
Sure.
They all want to be king.
Nice.
Is anybody left to be king in that show?
Just the Mad Queen.
Some of the dogs are still around, aren't they?
One, I thought.
I never watched it.
I think Ghost is the only one. There was left.
A figure sits upon the throne in the middle of the throne room.
Alright, so we're just going to have someone kite around the Helm Horrors then. Maybe Zacchaeus, do you want to kite? And then we'll take out the Archwizard?
Yeah,
Sure.
I have to admit, I have not been watching any of the most recent seasons of Game of Thrones. I don't have cable, for one. That's the big reason. But also, I'm kind of waiting for the books, right? Because I sort of learned Game of Thrones from the books, and I don't want to get all that stuff spoiled. But at some point, I'm just going to give up and then probably just binge watch the last two or three seasons.
Take the horror to the yellow gooey thing. They get stuck.
Throne strikes me as one of those shows that would probably just be better to watch it all at once when the show's over.
I have to admit, because I don't have cable, I've just been buying them on Blu-ray when I get a good discount on them, that sort of thing. And that's been a pretty good way to go for me.
Just make sure chat's over here.
And not only do you get the nice look on Blu-ray, because it really is a pretty looking show, but you can sort of binge watch it like that.
The wall is still adorned with his prized possession, a magical Mistdrannan painting.
Oh, what chest do you want?
I don't know. It's all good.
All of them?
Good point.
Alright, so a couple of questions. Who's going to Gen Con, Xylo says? Not me this year, unfortunately. Anyone here going to Gen Con? You going, Patrick?
No.
Wish.
I know there is the gathering for buffs taking place at the Severin Bar. But I can't make it this year. I've got my son with me, and that's just keeping me busy, so can't afford the trip. Hopefully next year, though. The other question is, speaking of books, do I read or have I read any of the D&D novels? Yes, I have read many of the D&D novels. Certainly not all of them, just because there are quite a few. But I've read quite a few. What is my favorite, though? I don't know. Return to Brockmere? The old Endless Quest book? Deep cut, I know. I really like Marsheila Rockwell's, The Skein of Shadows, and the other one that she did. Can't think of the name of it right now. The Eberron ones. I've read all the Dritz ones, and most of the Elminster ones. And they were okay.
I'm just following those traps or wherever you're going.
Why has it not been looted?
I'm just got half hour to kill, so I'm killing things.
Dungeon crawl.
Good dungeon to dungeon crawling.
So, have any of you read the Endless Quest books? Do you know what I'm talking about, or is that too deep a cut? They were the old Choose Your Own Adventures that were based on AD&D.
I think I did. I've read too much in my life.
I've not typically read very many Dungeons & Dragons books. More because I just didn't... I was reading other books.
Dungeon of Doom.
Star Wars and... Redwall and know what I was reading most of the time.
Quest for the Rainbow Dragons? I can't remember what they were all called now. Unfortunately. But Return to Brockmere was the one with the green book on it, the elf with the amulet. Highly influential when I was like 8 years old.
I don't think I've ever found him before. Ethos.
Well, you really just get a key for it, so. You don't really need to do it, but. King Cosmas, any plans to add more locations?
Oh no!
To the teleport scrolls, like Amrath? No, not really. That's not to say we couldn't do it. I just, if the answer is do we have any plans to do it, no. We haven't really discussed doing that.
I mean, you really are no more than like two hops away from basically anywhere except for Eveningstar. Take a teleport scroll to like Harbor, or take that ship to Marketplace and then continue to your ship, or to the Haunted Hall under Hall of Heroes. I'm having trouble here.
Yeah,
and
right.
And go anywhere.
Yeah, I think that's the big thing is, you know, we need to justify why we need to do the work. I mean, it'd be nice. I mean, I guess it would be nice, but there's guild airships and all that sort of thing now. It seems less relevant.
My understanding is we've got it easy in terms of travel.
Mm-hmm.
I've heard tell of people in other games that shall not be named of saying, go to here, going and cooking dinner and coming back.
Indeed.
You have broken into a crypt of some sort. It's ancient. It looks like this place was sealed when Rivior's keep was built. What is in here?
That's not horrible.
Even Rivior had not wanted to stir.
And I happen to know that we're at least looking at some options that might, I can't really talk about yet, but might make that even better.
Sweet. Guild ships do go to Three Barrel Cove, by the way. Someone in the chat was saying they don't. It's in the other option, but you can get there.
It's also a quick hop to House Deneath, the teleportation portal there. And then you can just pop on down to the docks.
And if you're in the Eveningstar, you go into the Hall of Heroes, you can teleport quickly to, what, the docks, Stormhorn, etc.
It's not so much high level, I think you just have to... For getting the Three-Wheel Cove, I think you just have to have the right thing on your ship. I don't think it's that high a level.
Do we have any plans for future new races? Yeah, as a matter of fact, Sev talked in the producer's letter a little bit about that, that, you know, it's not something that we're promising at this point, but it is absolutely something we would like to do. So, you know... Mm-hmm.
Asimar and Tieflings, right?
Yep. Like, it's way too early to say, yes, it'll be coming in update X or anything like that, but it's absolutely something we would like to do.
Here's what I want to know. Why did you turn the Mimic Festival off?
I want that all the time.
Well, you know, there's some mixed opinions on it, right? I mean, to be honest, some people loved it, some people really didn't. So it's like, well, we want people to like the things we're doing. So if people want it turned off, then okay.
Can we do the statue over here?
Oh, yeah, I suppose.
I was taught that, you know, with the Mimic Vest, that even at 1% chance of anything turning, I mean, you'll still get the, you know, you kill a Mimic, you'll still get that loot that was in a remote chest, but remain legible.
So if we were to bring back the Mimicon, I think what we would probably end up doing is, well, at the very least, we'd need to redo the loot tables, right? Because the loot tables got used for Night Revels after Maybar. And I think the other thing we'd probably try to do is remove at least one layer of randomness from it. Because remember, you turned in basically widgets to get the pages or whatever to get the, or the cards to get the item. And so I think we would just make it, you would collect widgets and then select whatever item you wanted.
That sounds perfect.
But again, you know, that would involve, I mean, we're essentially redoing the entire loot table from the ground up on that thing, so it wouldn't be an insignificant project.
There might still be something of value left.
The double blind thing isn't so bad when you're talking about consumables, but when it's you're trying to get the Maybar loot or like a specific item and you have to then do the kind of double randomness thing, that's where it got a little.
Right. That's called getting rid of mummy rot.
Yeah, it's MTD. Took care of that all right.
Yeah, that's gonna be well. I like Macabre's point there. Before you bring back the Mimic Festival, you need to add Mimics to the Monster Manual.
Well, no. Remember, I mean, I know that, like I said in the past, we've not always been 100% consistent on it, but as a general rule, event monsters are not meant to go into the Monster Manual. This is by design.
Sure, take all the fun out of it.
And the reason for that is, you know, we may, like, see with Maybar, for example, you know, there are times when events don't come back. I mean, ideally, most of them historically have, but there's no real promise that we're always going to bring it back, you know? And so we want to not put them in the Monster Manual because we want you to be able to earn anything that's in there.
I don't see any real stacks against me. Normally you'd see stacks of electrical dots. There they are. One tough gnome.
The live statue of Muir falls into pieces and is still.
Edward T says, so when we did like the Liches and Night Revels, it was by accident? Yeah, basically. I mean, I don't know if it was so much by accident as it was, I think people just kind of cajoled us into doing it. But in general, ooh, I see a Necklace of Mystic Eidolons. That's cool.
Anyone need?
I'll take it if you don't want it.
There you go.
But in general, you know, it's not meant to have event stuff in there. Because we haven't always been all that consistent with it, but whatever.
Well, I mean, the only place it would really matter would be the hunter, right? Like, the counters wouldn't really make a huge difference. It's just for hunter purposes.
Yeah.
He has a point there.
But let's say, for example, that you can't take part in an event, like, say, because you're always gone between October and February of some year, just because, I don't know, whatever reason.
Well, yeah, sure.
You know, then you're never going to be able to do this thing in the Monster Manual, and that is not generally something we want to encourage.
No, I totally understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's a way to add it to the Monster Manual and for a counter and not have it add to, as a hunter.
Yeah, I don't know either. That's a good question.
Stonework gives way to a natural cavern.
Changing the topics for a little bit, Maku Bry says, I mentioned Caneth crafting. Info would be coming maybe next week. Any more info on that? I could just say that it's in front of the Players' Council right now. They've been seeing a couple of new threads in recent weeks on it, so it's just a matter of time. Once we sort of have the feedback from there that we're looking for, whenever folks feel it's ready, we'll move that over. I would expect not today, just because people are busy and it's the holiday weekend, but probably next week, maybe? I don't know. I can talk to No Worries and sort of see what he wants to do with it.
Okay, I think I'll grab this guy, okay?
Yep.
After I put down another trap.
Someone says, are mana pots no longer in chest loot? Not seen for a long time. Yeah, they are. They should be. Pretty sure I've seen some.
Didn't be the first time they disappeared.
I guess now that you've mentioned it, I don't recall seeing it, but they're also in daily dice and such now, so. Eric,
wow, we
should,
we're working.
Yeah, we should move, take this fight away from the spirit, so he doesn't get hit.
Just hit.
Here we see. Bring him over by me. Bring those guardians over by me.
They're trapped right now.
Oh yeah, King Cosmo says, yes, got one yesterday. There you go. Great to hear.
Yeah, I pulled like 6 cosmetic hair dyes yesterday.
Oh really? That's pretty funny.
Including a new one I've never seen before, lavender.
Nice. I just got one from the Leister here not that long ago either. I wonder. Weird luck, I guess. Why are they going after you, Urlok?
Which is probably in their way. Or the anger because I put down the trap, I don't know.
I know one of the things the Players' Council is talking about in regard to Caneth crafting is how sort of quickly the expectation is that people should be able to level up and that sort of thing. You know, we're going to be preserving people's progress, but also readjusting the system, right? So, you know, if you're max crafting now, the goal isn't to make you necessarily a max crafter under the new system, because you're going to still need to earn the additional benefits, right? But we want to put you in a basically equal place from where you were. And so that's what some of the conversations that are happening now is where do you people feel that should fall?
I know one of the biggest concerns, you know, in all the pre-cursing discussions was nobody wants to feel like they've lost XP all that
right.
time. That's being considered as well.
Yeah. Yeah, and then there's a discussion about, quote, grind. How grindy is it? How grindy should it be? And that's, you know, kind of more of a subjective sort of discussion that's taking place.
Part of that conversation is trying to find good terminology, good objective terminology.
don't know, I always thought the grind was more with all the clicking than anything else.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Yeah, I'm not going to disagree with you there.
If they can remove the click grind, I think that everybody will like it.
Where do the purple head crabs come from? The cosmetic head crabs. Those are only daily dice, is that correct?
The thinking cap?
Correct.
Yeah, that's gold daily dice. It was a roll of 100, if I remember right.
I thought they were available for a limited time somewhere.
Yeah, see, I seem to think that too, but now I couldn't remember where that was.
No, I don't think they've ever been available anywhere except for the dice. And I don't think they stay that way. Of course, I have.
Alright, giant's about dead.
Yep.
Spear him. Just cut the spear.
I do, and there we go. I was having a leg stutter.
King Cosmos says, twice now, Didio has said the materials gained from the Mimic event were going to, quote, disappear from our inventory as they are still in mine. Glitcher, is that not going to happen? Also, are the first set of cards of no you any longer? It was the Night Revel stuff that was said to disappear, not the Mimic.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think we wouldn't make them disappear just in case we did bring it back. So we wouldn't, you know, if we're going to have a disappearing ingredient, we want to be pretty upfront about that. I'm not quite sure what he means about the first set of cards, but if he's asking essentially will the 8th anniversary card set ever come back, the answer to that is no.
Just remember, even though they're not useful, you can still put them in your energy gallery.
Yep.
Oh, there's a question for you, Cordovan. Are there any current plans for the image gallery to be expanded?
I haven't heard of any plans. I think if we redid the Mimic Haunt, it would maybe be worth considering whether we should put some new cards in it, but I don't know that there's been any serious discussion of that.
Fair answer.
Pretty cool, though.
The cards really cheap for Mimic ingredients. Like, come out with 10 cards and just make them like 10 ingredients each or something.
Yeah, that's a cool idea.
So if you want them, you can go get them.
And just to be clear, the reason on the 8th anniversary cards was there were some shenanigans that took place. So we could never really reopen the ability to turn them in for things.
It'd be kind of cool if some of the new players were able to get the cards, though.
Mm-hmm.
If you could get older cards from other things, other events.
Let's see, why don't we head on over to the kobold cannons?
Yeah. I think that's a good test for a rogue. Go stand in front of those cannons for a while.
Mystic Dragon Raider says, Rider says, I have an old 90-minute three-barrel cove pass. I don't know if it still works. I think it should. It should work.
If it doesn't, you can probably submit a ticket.
Yeah.
I really wish they wouldn't be bound. It's much easier to give those away, but I can't understand why they are bound.
Well, the reason they are bound is because otherwise it would be a way to basically bypass an adventure pack sale, right? Because you could just go and, trade it off to someone for far less turbine points and just keep doing that.
To watch out for more of these crossbows.
As you did for not joining the Kobold Consortium.
Kobold priests are performing rituals behind this barrier.
They don't hate you, they're just testing out. They're QA testers for new crossbow technology. Oh man, I died at the hands of kobolds. That'd be embarrassing if it wasn't me.
I'm trying to drive it. The fire. They don't like me
is aggro pretty serious there, Patrick.
Yeah. Make sure they got there first.
Chance for more backpack space. We just had shared account bank space. The issue we're running into for backpack space, or personal character bank space, is that ultimately it can bloat character data. So we can only go so big before it starts to have a detrimental impact on the game. And so I would never say never on. But we would need to do some serious investigation to make sure we can kind of get away with it before we were to do something like that.
You can't use the turret against them.
No wonder I'm not jumping. I still have my boots on. So why am I not jumping? Okay. Yes, absolutely. As intended. Is there an epic elite pit? No, but there should be.
Yeah. So, what do you use for your attack mod on those ballistic? Intelligence?
I don't know. That's a good question.
I don't think there is an attack mod. I think it just hits you if you hit it. It's just a collision, yeah. I think.
Unless it's like a reflex save. Mystic Dragon Rider says, is that what causes slower loading on some characters in particular? Is it the extra backpack space? Probably not that one-to-one. It's more of a cumulative effect, where as character data bloat gets bigger and bigger, it kind of slows things down for everybody. In terms of why some characters might load more slowly than others, if you have a huge number of past lives, for example, then that could perhaps play a role. Otherwise, if you are have fallen victim to one of the, say, kind of quote, stacking enhancement issues that we've been working in recent months to squash, that can cause that to happen as well. So those are probably the two biggest reasons. And yeah, why don't we finish out here? I'm gonna go through the sales, and then I'll probably call it a day here.
Yeah, the backpack space too is part of it is character balance too, right? Like, if you have a limited amount of stuff that you can carry, then it helps with game balance.
Yeah. Although I suppose people, it's not. I mean, I think you're right if it were an issue, but I don't know that that's ever really been a big issue for us in terms of why we don't do it. Really, I mean, especially because it's something we theoretically can sell, right? I mean, we have motivation to offer as much as possible, and we're kind of at that position where we feel this is about all we can do at the moment.
Yeah, the character of mine that takes the longest to load is my arrow carrier. We have something like 40 quivers, all of them maxed. All slaying arrows, blah blah blah. He takes a while to load.
Yeah, that sounds like maybe a thing.
If you're having major issues with storage, create a secondary account, or even just create a dummy guild, and then get an airship and get the the room that you can have a whole bunch of chests in.
Mm-hmm.
Then you'd be good to go.
I agree with Urlock and Party Chat. Sell stuff. We need to go on loot diets. I am as much a victim as anybody here, right? I mean, I have got 5 bank alts per server. But, I put stuff in there and it's like a bag of holding that I never see again. I never take any of the stuff out of that. I have stuff that's been in there for 7 years now that I've never touched. Do I really need to have it in there?
Well, I like keeping things around that, are really hard to get. They're useless now. I'm trying to think of something. Ring of Spellstorm. It's still useful, but really, it's not. I keep it just because, hey, I got it.
I have a bank alt on Arganesson that is only for adamantine and mithril armors. That's how bad I am.
Nice.
Malicia is having therapy sessions.
I thought it was Fred that was going to do it. I mean, I thought Fred was far more effective. Not as pretty, but definitely more effective.
Yeah. All right, let me quick pop on over to our sales page here. I'm going to quick pop on over to the sales page and offer a few tips here. Let people take a look at it. Thanks for joining me, you guys. Really appreciate it. It's nice to have you here. Hope you have a good DDO weekend. So I can't have a voice chat on while I'm doing this, so here we go. I just wanted to quick show we do have, this is the DDO Market, and you can just find that by going to DDO.com, go to the store tab, click down to DDO Market. We've got the Collector's Edition for Shadowfell for $12.50. We have Standard Edition for $7.50. You can also find Menace of the Underdark for as little as $5 there. This starter pack here is one you're going to want to take a look at. Like I say, this offers a free pet, the permanent cleric hireling, some XP elixirs, 250 turbine points, and catacombs, and it's $2.50 for 250 turbine points plus other stuff. So there you go. Recommended. If you want half orcs, that's $5. Druid is $5. And then we have our regular turbine point stuff, which is not on sale. So it's just the packs, for example. And this runs through Monday. So you want to take advantage of this now if you can. And, this is also available on Steam if you're a Steam DDO player there as well. So, all right, everyone, that's going to wrap it up for Friday afternoon here on twitch.tv/DDOstream and youtube.com/DungeonsAndDragons/live. Thank you very much for joining me. A quick thanks to Angela and Lawful Eye over on our YouTube chat as well. Appreciate you guys being here. Hope you have a good DDO weekend. Hope you're enjoying Crystal Cove. You can find our guide to Crystal Cove on DDO.com. 9 o'clock tonight is Pikers Anonymous. 6 p.m. on Saturday, Papagayo de TR. 9 p.m. on Sunday is Shoe Cobbles A. And then Minion Monday, I believe, will be here this Monday. Despite it being a holiday in the U.S., they're mostly Brits, I think. And that'll be 4 p.m. Eastern. And you can find our full schedule here on twitch.tv/DDOstream. Hope you guys have a great weekend. Hope you have a happy holiday. Talk to you again soon.